Hey guys, this is MJ and Izzy from Endless RVing, and at this time there are thousands upon thousands of people getting into RVing every day. On Facebook and other areas, we see questions all the time that people have before even getting into RVing. So in this video, we're going to talk about six questions that people have before they even get an RV.
And now you're gonna wanna stay to the end of this video because every one of these questions are pretty important. MJ pulled them out of like the most common questions like she said online.
All right, number one is, do you need a CDL to operate a motorhome? Now,
maybe.
The answer is, it depends on your state. So in New Jersey, we do not need a CDL. Anybody can just hop into the captain's chair and go off on down the road, but it depends on the state that you're in.
Yeah, so like MJ said, New Jersey, don't, as long as it's not a commercial vehicle, you can literally jump into a 50,000 pound bus and drive it. Now, some states are not like that. I know Texas, or at least, I shouldn't say I know. I know from the forums that apparently in Texas, depending on if your vehicle is a certain weight, it's usually 26,000 pounds, that you may need a certain endorsement on your license. Now, with all that being said, it's not going to hurt you to have a CDL. You'll probably be a much better driver if you have a CDL. Maybe we'll get a CDL when, like, we have more time than to shoot videos and work all the time. But it's certainly something that's not going to hurt you. So to answer your question, it really does depend on the state, and you should know what the laws of your state are. All right, number two, how much is this going to cost me regarding RVing? Again, that really depends on how much you want to spend, right? And how you want an RV. Mm-hmm. So it can go from low end, you make your own RV and you pull it with your mom's car, up to you spend $3 million on an RV. It all depends.
Right, it depends on how you want to live. Are you a minimalist and you want something small and you want to spend a small amount of money? Are you a minimalist and you want to spend a lot of money, maybe a Class B? Are you like us where we do like our space, but we didn't want to spend $3 million? So it's really what I would recommend to people is, as you're going into this, to write down, make a list of everything that's really critical for you, that your must-haves, and then you can start narrowing down to see really what's going to be the best choice for you.
So let's talk about just general, and this, we're just going to talk new price, okay?
Right.
To kind of give you an idea, we'll talk about travel trailers, which are the most common. Those are going to be low end of around probably 15,000 up to high end, mid 40s, maybe low 50s for a real high end. Then we'll go to your fifth wheel, which is the most common, low end, high 30s. Low 40s up to well over $200,000, we've seen them. And then we're gonna go motorized, we'll go Class B. Those can be 55, 60,000 up well over 200,000. Class C, again, low end 60,000 up to high, under 200, high hundreds. Class A, low 100,000, six figures, up to
millions.
Millions, essentially.
Millions and millions.
And there's other things in between, pop-ups and A-frames and all different ones, but we're just kind of giving you a general price on newer RVs new RVs.
And also how much will it cost. Again, it's not just the RV, it's everything that has to go in it, which we'll get to shortly. All right, so number three is what we just mentioned. What supplies do I need? So you're not just purchasing an RV, you're purchasing a home and you do have to furnish it. So there's going to be those necessities. So you're going to need a sewer hose, you're going to need toilet paper, you're going to need cutlery and dishes,
freshwater hose
and a surge protector. Again, some people don't, but to us that's a definite necessity.
Again, it's personal. Some things that are a necessity for some are not for others. For us, internet's a necessity.
Yeah.
That has cost us, $1,000+ on an internet setup, because that is something that's really necessary for us. For somebody else, their grill setup may be necessary, or an ice maker to make drinks, or a cooler to have beers.
Right.
That may be super necessary. So it all depends on what your camping is like and what you want.
So something that was definitely necessary for us was upgrading our suspension, which we did with a lot of different things in the beginning when we first got an LE. But we have recently upgraded to Liquid Spring.
Which brings us to, this video is sponsored by Liquid Spring. We'd like to thank them. If you're looking for the very best suspension upgrade in your Class A, B, C, or Super C motorhome, Liquid Spring is hands down the best.
They're phenomenal. For our viewers and subscribers, you can save up to $750 off a new Liquid Spring system by using the code RIDEENDLESSLY.
Now, if you are looking to see what the hype is about and you want to drive a liquid spring motorhome, in the description below, we're going to have where the demo vehicles are for liquid spring and where you can drive them for free. I was just telling MJ on the way up, I drove. It is such a difference. Like, I'm so happy driving this motorhome now because it drives like a diesel. It's really unbelievable how good it drives.
Yeah.
Also in the context below will be the number for Wayne Wells from Liquid Spring. If you have any questions. So again, if you're looking for the very best suspension upgrade for your motorhome, look no further than Liquid Spring. So number four is a question we see all the time. Should I full-time or should I part-time? This is a personal question that really depends on what your situation is, right? Like for us, we're probably never going to full-time. It's probably going to be most time.
And then you have people, like we have a neighbor that is no time and the RV has been sitting there literally for like 5 years.
Well, it's housing rats, I think. Yeah. I don't know. It's not housing people.
So, yes. So we know a lot of people. We have a lot of friends that are full-time, some part-time. And again, it depends at the point you are in your life. So, for example, we have some friends, Alice and Larry from Downsizing Makes Sense. And they had an empty nest and they sold everything and took off on the road and they are loving it. And mm-hmm. we love watching their journey too, because it's just, you know, they're going everywhere mm-hmm. and they're having a blast. And we're not at that point in our life yet. And when we are, we probably still won't full time, but that could change too. We used to want a full time, but now most time. It really just depends on where you are in your life, what you're looking to do, and how you want to live.
Number five, what kind of RV should I get? Well, we can't really answer that because that's kind of personal. What we can tell you is what certain RVs migrate, what certain people migrate to certain RVs, right? So like if you are looking, we'll talk about ourselves. We like a lot of space. We like when we're going down the road, that big windshield, you can take everything in. We like staying at places with full hookups. We love staying at resorts. So for us, a Class A motorhome really made sense. Now in the future, maybe your Super C would make sense, right? Because you kind of have all that, but you have more carrying capacity.
Really,
and I mean, there's, MJ loves them, I love them. We were more of just not taking much with us, and we want to be a little more nimble, maybe a Class B, right? You can get in and out of places. You can park in a parking lot kind of like unseen, or maybe a Class C if you want a little bit of more room.
Right, and a little easier to drive too. If you want a sprawling, is that the word?
Estate?
A sprawling palace, you know, where you actually feel home, where you're getting the most room. In most cases, a fifth wheel is going to be a great way to go because you're going to plop it down and you have a full kitchen and full bed. Mm-hmm. You can really spread your wings at a fifth wheel. And we've actually dabbled in that idea as well, but we keep coming back to the Super C.
Or if you have a limited budget and you just want to get into RVing, like when we first got into it, mm-hmm. a travel trailer. Travel trailers are by far the most popular, and they can range from like this little 13 footers up to 40 feet. Some of them are really nice. So that may be something that you want to get into, and they are much more affordable versus the motorized. So again, what kind of RV should I get? It's really going to depend on what type of camper you are and what your budget is.
Number six is, will I be able to work on the road? I know a lot of times people are hesitant to get out there because they don't know how they're going to make money. There are so many ways to make. If somebody wants to make money, they will find a way to make money. And especially now in these COVID COVID days, a lot of people who used to work in an office are actually now working remotely. So even more people, I think, are hitting the road, taking their jobs mm-hmm. with them. There are so many jobs that you can do from the road. I run a business from the road, and I have people that work back in, you know, in New Jersey. So when we're out, I'm still running the business. You can be a virtual assistant. You can do YouTube channel. Anything.
Traveling there. So, I mean, listen, like MJ said,
the list is endless.
If you want to make money, you can make money. There's mm-hmm. work camping. For us, it will be my pension, right? That will be coming in. Your work, YouTube, and whatever else we get our hands into, which I'm sure we will, because we both know how to make money, right? So it all depends, again, how much you want and what your skills are, but there's always an opportunity to work if you wanted to, at least in this great country that we live in.
If you hustle, you can definitely get there.
And just piggybacking off of number six is a bonus, and we told you to stay to the end because this is a pretty important one. So a lot of these jobs that MJ's talking about, we're talking about, they're going to require some kind of internet service. And now we did a quick like 1-minute video regarding our setup. We'll link it above. That has worked out pretty well for us, but technology is always changing and it's getting better. And something that's really going to kind of change the game, according to SpaceX, Elon Musk, by the end of 2021, Starlink, if you don't know what that is a high speed, low orbit satellite internet that's going to be somewhat affordable price. And what essentially will let you do is get high speed internet pretty much everywhere, anywhere in the country, when it's ultimately at its, you know, fully functioning level.
And where we are, it would come in perfectly handy right now.
Yeah, so you're going to be able to be out in the desert where there's no cell service and get high speed internet. That's really a game changer.
Yeah, because we have very limited service right now. We're out in the middle of a forest and it would be really helpful.
Yeah, so internet, super important. And again, I think it's going to be really changing the way people operate and work in the future in remote locations. So in the comments below, let us know, did we answer some of the questions you had? Are there certain questions that you have that we didn't answer? Put it in the comments below. And for myself and MJ, we thank you guys for watching, and we'll see you on the road.